Hey everyone, a very good morning to all of you. Myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs, I welcome you all in this video where we are going to discuss a lot of interesting questions. But before that, if you are a newcomer here and you have not subscribed to our channel, so please subscribe and hit the bell notification because this will help you keep in touch with our channel and the new uploads that we make on our channel. And guys, this is the Telegram group where you can enjoy the free quizzes that we provide. Also, we provide relevant information related to the examination. So if you want to keep updated with the information as well as the quizzes, you can join this Telegram group. The link of this group is in description below. So you can join this group by clicking on that link. And this is the new course for RBI Grade B 2022, where you will get PDFs, videos and mocks. Along with this, you will also get your preparation for final interviews through mock interviews. And this is the booklet that you will get. And in this booklet, you will have all these books that are mentioned here. And right now, we are running a 30% discount on this course. So if you are willing to avail this course, then you can use RBI 30 coupon code in order to get this 30% discount. And this is the number which you can use to call us if you have any query related to the exam or related to the course. So that was all about the introduction. Now let's begin with the first question. What is India's rank in the Global House Price Index first quarter 2021 report of Knight Frank? So first of all, you should know this fact that Knight Frank is a real estate consultancy firm that releases the indices related to real estate. Now it is headquartered in London. So remember this fact as well about this organization. Now, as far as this question is concerned, so let me tell you that India's rank for this year is 55th. Now, this is not a proudful rank that India has achieved because the total number of countries assessed in this index was 56. And out of these 56 countries, India has ranked at 55th position, which is the second last position. Now, which country has topped this index? It is Turkey. And which country is at the bottom of this index? It is Spain. Now, as far as India is concerned, you should know this fact that this is a 12 positions down. India's position has dived down by 12 positions this year. Now, what is the reason for this downfall in India's ranking? The reason is the fall in the housing prices. So in India, the house prices downfall by 1.6% in the first quarter of 2021. So this is the primary reason. Apart from this, you would also know this fact that real estate sector has been facing some difficulty for 2019, or I would say before that also. So it has been quite a period of time for which the real estate sector has been facing issues in India. For resolving those issues, if you remember, in the year 2019, the Ministry of Finance created the Swami Fund. So guys, here your task is to tell me the total corpus of this Swami Fund. If you remember about the Swami Fund, so you should also know this thing that this fund was created to complete these stalled projects of real estate sectors, because there were many projects in 2019 that were not completed due to the financial crisis being faced by the real estate sector. And in order to overcome that crisis, the Ministry of Finance launched this Swami Fund. Now here, do not forget to answer your question, that is the total corpus of Swami Fund. Now as far as this index is concerned, we have completed all the facts related to this index. Moving further to the second question, who has become the first woman to be appointed as Secretary General of United Nations Conference on Trade and Development? So out of these many options, the right answer is option A, Rebecca Greenspan. Now remember that she is an economist and the former Vice President of Costa Rica. Now she is the first woman. Apart from this, she is also the first Central American to head this United Nations Conference on Trade and Development. So this is another fact related to her that you should remember. Now we are discussing about this United Nations Conference on Trade and Development. So you should also know this fact that this was established in the year 1964 as an intergovernmental commission under the United Nations General Assembly. So remember that it is established as the permanent Commission under the United Nations General Assembly and the year of its establishment. Now, what is the purpose of this UN CTAD? The major purpose is to deal with the issues related to trade and development. If you remember that the reports related to remittances or related to FDI inflow is released by the same organization. So here, remember this thing that this organization or this commission, particularly this commission, releases the data related to trade and development. Okay, so that was all about this UN CTAD. Your task is to tell me that what is the capital of Costa Rica. So capital and currency of Costa Rica, that you have to tell me in the comment section below. Next question is, Google has announced to develop an open subsea cable to provide robust internet connectivity between US, Brazil, dash and dash. So we have Uruguay, Argentina, Costa Rica, both A and B, both B and C in the options, out of which the right answer is option B. That is, Uruguay and Argentina are the two countries that are being connected along with US and Brazil with this open subsea cable. Now remember that this open subsea cable is named as Fermina cable. And this is going to be the world's longest cable, which will provide robust internet connectivity between North America and South America. So here from this map, you can see that this cable is going to connect US, Brazil, Uruguay and Argentina. So these are the four countries, and from region wise, or if you see this picture, you can yourself assess how long this cable would be in order to provide robust internet connectivity. Now, this name, this Fermina cable, has been given after a Brazilian author. Your task is to find out the full name of that author. So on that note, let's move on to the next question. With which country has India signed an MOU to bring Indian domestic workers in the country within the ambit of a legal framework that streamlines their recruitment and provides them with protection of the law? Bahrain, Kuwait, Oman, Qatar, Saudi Arabia are in the options, out of which the right answer is Kuwait. So this MOU, let me tell you the basic purpose of this MOU. So this MOU is going to bring all the domestic workers which are of Indian origin under the ambit of law. So this will protect the recruitment rights and the human rights of the Indian domestic workers working in Kuwait. That is the whole purpose of signing this MOU. Now remember this thing that mechanism for 24-hour assistance will also be established for these domestic workers in Kuwait. Also, a joint committee will be established so that the monitoring work related to this MOU can be done, whether the MOU is being implemented in the country or not. So that would be the purpose of this joint committee. So it will take care of the implementation of this MOU. Now guys, Kuwait is a member of Gulf Cooperation Council, which is a council of six Gulf countries. Your task is to tell me how many other countries are members of the Gulf Cooperation Council. Basically, it is a council of six members. So your task is to tell me the names of the other members of this council. Next question is, with which state has Flipkart partnered for medicines from the Sky project to deliver medicines by using drones to remote areas of the state? Telangana, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Kerala and Karnataka are in the options, out of which Telangana is the right answer. So Telangana and Flipkart have partnered for this medicines from the Sky project, under which drones will be used to deliver the vaccines and other medicinal equipments or the medicines to the remote areas of the state where the road connectivity is not very good. So that is all for this question. There is nothing much that you can remember. So here comes the end of this video. I hope that you have really enjoyed the video. Thank you so much for watching this video.